Baby, could you? I got too much on my mind right now. I ain't got the time to get you sent.
Start the regular season by selecting your season goal.
Right now. Tell that hero, tell, get my baby 35. $5,000 for a handbag like Saint Laurent, baby. Give me love, that money, baby. 100,000 plus 100,000 my whip. 30,000 plus 30,000 my wrist. We got those bad that's. I got too much on my mind right now. I ain't got the time to get you sailing right now. I got too much on my mind right now. Tell that hero, tell, get my baby.
Chucky is back.
Thank you, Coach. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to Oakland, California. Tonight, we wrap a busy first week of the season with a second of two on a Monday night between the Los Angeles Rams and the Oakland Raiders. And the hands team for the Raiders able to secure it. So here are the Raiders now with great starting field position. They'll be led out by their quarterback out of Fresno State. It's the Pro Bowler, Derek Carr.
I spent plenty of time this offseason listening to people debate about whether Derek Carr is actually a top 10 quarterback in the NFL or whether he's more a middle-of-the-pack guy. If he's a top 10 quarterback in the league, then you're thinking playoffs for your team.
Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
I think we'll see more of them trying to get him the football out of the backfield. They love what he can do in open space, and they believe that he creates mismatches they can exploit.
On the ground, this is Jalen Richard. And some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41. Call it about a gain of three, and they'll be looking at a third and seven coming up. The defense here for the Rams.
And defensive tackle Aaron Donald, when you evaluate him, you're looking for flaws. You can't find any. This guy has the ability to single-handedly take over a game. Wrecks it inside, outside. You can't run it against him. And good luck trying to throw it downfield when he's in the face of the quarterback.
And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. A big third down conversion with a gain of 28.
And that's how you pick up a first down. Not only does he make the catch, but has enough body control to get his feet down inbounds, toe tapping and dragging to make sure he gets it done.
His throw in.
complete.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
Carr again here on second and 10. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. Now they'll try to convert on third and 6 after the 4-yard completion. Carr to throw again. And that is incomplete.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? The zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
The kick by Tavecchio is good. And the Raiders jump out to a 3-0 advantage. So our initial drive of the night ends in 3 points. Maybe not exactly what this home crowd wanted, but they'll take the early lead.
They will take it. You're exactly right. Everybody wants a touchdown. But in this case, good opening drive, put points on the board. And a lot of coaches do believe the first team to score in the game, statistically, often ends up the winner.
Golf will lead the Rams up here first and 10 at about the 32. Now the first carry here for Todd Gurley. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know, you know better than I, he has the ability to take over a game, so what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure.
And this will be caught at the 30. A gain of 39 that time. Well, it's one thing to grab it with one hand, but when you make a catch of that distance, quite another.
Yes, sir. I mean, that one right there, we keep talking about the high-flying antics that we're seeing from receivers nowadays, doesn't matter what spot they start in. But when it actually does happen in the heat of battle, it brings me right out of my seat.
9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second and one.
And that was a good run. This was only one of 9 guys to go over 1,000 yards in 2017. And I think you can't let him run wild here.
What do you think, 100 yards, the measuring stick?
Always. That is the threshold. You want to keep him under that if you want to play good defense.
And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
All right, quick observation, Brandon, because early on in this game, I'm seeing linebackers putting their noses close to the line of scrimmage.
And my guess is the wheels are turning on that other sideline. As a play caller, you're filing that away right now, aren't you?
Yeah, you're trying to find that opportunity later on when you can play action them or stick something to them between the second and the third level. Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
A gain of 7 that time. Second goal. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his...
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Los Angeles. Todd Gurley, a 3-yard... carry for Marshawn Lynch. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Well, forget about finding a lane there. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Probably fortunate he was able to hold on to the football.
So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. Carr out of throw. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
He kind of forced that one there, didn't he? It's almost like he predetermined where he was going to go with the football.
Yeah, he wasn't really going through progressions. He wanted to go to his top guy. You do that against this defense, they'll make you pay, won't they?
Yeah, they certainly will. They react very quickly to the throw.
And the pressure will get to him. He goes down. Now there is a flag on the play, but this looks like holding on the offense. So instead of giving them another third down, they'll decline it, brings up fourth.
Now that's smart football right there. You don't even have to really spend a lot of time considering it. Just know that you're probably going to get the ball back. Good job declining that penalty.
It's a 47-yard punt, return of six. And the Rams will go on offense here with a first and 10. Now we turn our attention to the Rams here as the offense comes out. So many positive vibes around this club entering 2018. Their third season back in L.A., a new stadium on the way. And coming off of last year, Charles, and you said this to me in the car on the way over, it's going to be interesting to see what this year brings.
That's because they will actually be the team that's hunted now, and they haven't been that for a long time, meaning they're sitting on top of the NFC West. Many people think they might be the team to beat in the NFC overall, even with the Eagles and the Vikings staring at them. So explosive on offense last year. Defense kept getting better. And in the offseason, the defense added cornerback Marcus Peters and a defensive tackle Ndamukong Suh, both Pro Bowlers. They think that they're ready right now to challenge for a Super Bowl, and they intend to go for it.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Goff now to throw. And the third down pass falls incomplete.
It was no secret who they were trying to get the football to.
Well, no, they went to him on first down, second down, third down, all three incomplete.
Yeah, and when you're unable to connect and you force it in that direction, all you're doing is giving confidence to the defense. They feel like they're really hurting you in a big way.
For these Raiders, a couple of years ago, 12-4, 2017, big-time disappointment, 6-10. But as they head out on offense here, optimism abound because on headset number one is a man named John Gruden.
And I would expect this team to take on his image in a big way. And I'm not just talking about the media look, right, with the snarling face and all. I'm talking about what he demands from his teams. Toughness on both sides of the ball. So that means they're going to run the heck out of the football. Marshawn Lynch, get ready. You're going to get a lot more touches. Now on the defensive side,
Martavis Bryant. He's at the 40. 20. 10. And all the way in. Touchdown, Oakland. Martavis Bryant, an 80-yard touchdown. They'll start out on the ground with Gurley. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. On first and 10, Goff. And he will find his man on the outside. And he goes out right around the 39. That throw good for four. It's second down. They should have got more out of that, though. He was wide open.
I love how emphatic you are with that call because that's exactly what I was thinking. Wide open in the flat. Give him a ball that he can use to get upfield with, not just catch and go over the sideline. They cost himself some yardage there.
Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
He'll throw underneath for Gurley, and he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. Give him 2 yards on that play, and it'll be second down.
Well, it's tough to be a defender in today's NFL because there's so many things to account for in today's passing game, including the back sneaking out of the backfield. Not quite as bad as a turkey bowl where you have the center-eligible stuff, but still a lot of guys to account for.
He'll pick up only a yard there, and it'll leave him with a 3rd and 7.
And this is why aggressive defense coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
Back to throw, Goff. Dumps it off to Gurley. Good move by Gurley. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. The 21 yards there as they convert on third.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first.
Well, partner, when you ask anyone other than your QB to throw the ball, you must have a lot of confidence or you think you're really going to fake them out. And it looks like they did exactly that.
Yeah, going deep in the playbook and a great grab on the other end. And here he'll get it down to the 7. That throw good for 4. It's second down. Now on second down, this is Gurley. And that'll move him a little closer as he takes it from the 7 down to the 4-yard line.
He did have the touchdown run earlier, but not a heck of a lot more than that throughout this game.
No, not at all. In fact, I would say that this defense has done as good of a job on him as they have on any runner in recent memory. Here's Gall, and he's going to take this one in for a Rams touchdown. John Kelly, his first NFL reception. They start the drive with Lynch, and he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24.
Well, that one was over before it could get rolling. How about the D just knifing into the backfield and shutting that one down?
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a 2nd and 11. Carr gives to Lynch on the draw. Absolutely nobody fooled there. He's going nowhere fast as he stopped behind the line of scrimmage. That'll wind up going for a loss of 4. And they're going to be staring at a 3rd and long here. From the gun, it's Carr. And he'll have his man. That's Cooper. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. First catch of the new season for him, and he picks up the first.
It's funny, when I go back to our pregame meeting with Amari Cooper, and we mentioned, yeah, what if they play man coverage against you? He almost seemed offended by it, didn't he?
I'll beat it. That's basically what it said, right?
I mean, the best receivers we've ever talked to and covered, when you talk about covering them with one guy, they think that's a personal affront. If they feel like if they can't just beat one defender, then they're not very good. No surprise watching Marshawn Lynch scatter bodies as he runs, but I remember doing games of his at Cal, and I remember the moves, the jump cuts, the elusiveness, as well as the strength.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. A Raider first down as Carr finds Cooper.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
They go play action here on first down. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Amari Cooper, the intended target. And now it's second down.
I think he's a little trigger happy right there. And it turned into an ill-advised throw into their zone.
Well, we know he has confidence. He'll throw it any place, anytime, anywhere. That time it fell incomplete. They'll run to Marshawn Lynch. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him. Ready to go now in the second quarter. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis. It's the Raiders in possession of the football. They do, however, have a tough third and long coming up. Shotgun now for Carr. And this is going to be incomplete.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. So now here are the Rams as their offense comes back out. They're starting to pull away with this one. Early on that first quarter, they didn't look so great offensively. What has changed?
Sometimes it's just a matter of doing what you plan to do better. Sometimes you just put that all together and you execute. Other times, it's just in a simple adjustment in your game plan, finding a spot that maybe was a little weaker than maybe you thought, and going to that. So many different things, so many different ways.
Under a heavy rush, and down he goes.
Brandon, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
Third and long. It's gone. Escaping the pressure right. And now he'll turn, and off his back foot, he'll heave this deep. So they took a shot there on third down, couldn't get it. Now it's four.
Sure, that pass was incomplete as they made an attempt to get a big one downfield. But that's okay because the second part of that is if you don't get the completion, at least you've told the defense you're trying to stretch them out a little bit, and they may have to change accordingly.
A big kick that time, 52 yards. And the Raiders will take over now first and 10. Carr and the Raiders come up first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Working from the gun, it's Carr. And Nelson's got it here right side. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Second and five after the 5-yard completion on first down. Now Carr. And this is caught. A spectacular one-handed grab there. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down.
One-handed. Love the effort. Not much production on that play, though, huh?
Not a whole lot of yardage. You get that grab, you probably want a first down.
And he'll be the one in the film session. He'll be saying, hey, run that one back.
And he will not get away from the pressure here. Carr taken down. Here now, Johnny Townsend, as he's on to punt for Oakland. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And that one hits at the 7, but bounds into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. The Rams offense now making their way out to take over. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means they're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. A very nice pickup of 33 yards.
On any given pass play, you never know exactly where your exit points are going to be. And this play was flushed to his left, still on the run, able to accurately throw the football for a nice first down.
It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
Hey, kill, kill.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
Flushed out right. And a hit charted loose. It's incomplete.
That's very well timed there defensively because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. To throw is gone. And that is incomplete.
Certainly looked like they were getting ready to convert there on third down, but what an effort to get his hand on that one, knock it away, and brings up a fourth down decision.
Here's Johnny Hecker now as he's on to punt for L.A. And he's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. The Raiders offense now, they trot back out. And our game's hit a little bit of a lull here, a little bit of a snag. Punts on back-to-back drives.
And old-school coaches don't necessarily mind that. Didn't turn it over, right? Didn't create a big play for the other team. Right now, what you're looking for is can you gain an advantage in field position? And that's what both teams are seeking right now.
Yeah, they'll be seeking to gain that advantage here on this drive. They'll run it now out of the gun. Trying to bounce it outside, but he's only able to get it back to the line of scrimmage. No gain on that one as it brings up a 3rd and 10.
Perfectly designed blitz right there. They took that one from the grease board to the field because they were able to free up their linebacker to get into the backfield and spill the play.
He completes it to Bryant. And they're able to get this one across the 35. A Raider first down, 17 yards. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down.
That's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that, got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
And very little room to maneuver. He'll get this down to about the 39. Give him 3 yards on the run there. That still leaves him with a difficult 3rd and 8 coming up.
Sometimes your philosophies get challenged at times you don't want them to. They did try to stick to the running game on the first two plays. Didn't amount to much.
And now facing a 3rd and long at the outset of this drive. They've got another first down. The Raider passing game clicking on all cylinders right now.
Well, from an offense's perspective, that sure was pretty because the corner route, it's extremely difficult to defend from my perspective.
What we just saw there, is that sort of the evolution of the tight end position?
Yeah, I think it is because more and more tight ends are being treated like wide receivers. These are some agile players who can make a play in any spot on the field.
Back to the ground, this time Lynch. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. There to make the tackle, Samson Abukum.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. What that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. 23 yards on the play. And now with that completion, he's north of 200 yards here in the first half.
And he's going to break our statistician, Marvin, isn't he? Marvin right now is just tallying it up. Hope his hand doesn't hurt too much doing this or keeps hitting the calculator. But my goodness, what a start he is off to. By the end of this game, he could have monster numbers. He just wants to continue to be accurate.
On 2nd down, here's Carr. And this is Cook with the grab. And they work this near the 5. He'll be stopped at the 6. They've got another first down. The Raider passing game clicking on all cylinders right now.
But when you hit him on the move like that, and he's able to get into open field with a full head of steam, oh boy, it's going to be tough to get him down.
Yeah, there was a big window. They're lucky they did get him down. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. Only a yard on the completion. It's second and goal.
And partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal. Because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic.
And he's got his tight end, Cook, in the end zone. Touchdown, Raiders. Away to his left, throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. So a good spin move there before he's taken down. A nice little gain. Give him 8 on the play, and it'll bring up a second down.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense a good chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up the score.
So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down.
We all have habits. We can be somewhat predictable, and you know me pretty well on second down and short. What I like to say?
Play action.
Yeah, without a doubt. I thought that was a great spot to call it. Instead, didn't go their way, did it?
No, defense sold out for the run. Worked out well. There's Gaw. He's letting it fly for Cooks. And a shot taken on third down, unsuccessful. Fourth down now. Well, they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively, and then just continued there with that incompletion.
Yeah, definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. Those stop troops, they're enjoying things right now because they made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
Now it's Gaw. Forced out to his left.